I'm Chad Brown.
I'm Bear Brown.
We're not brothers.
But this is
The Cutting Edge. February 13th through 18th was Founders Week at MEHS.
February 15th, Wednesday, was Gathering of Cultures at the BJ McGillis Gymnasium.
Bear and Yaska had the story. Let's go take a look.
February 15th, Mount Edgecombe had Gathering of Cultures, where we had dance groups from many cultures, from Tlingit, Athabascan, and Yupik.
Edgecombe students packed the gym for outstanding performances by the various groups.
First, the local Tlingit group performed, and they really started the show. Next, our very own Yupik dance group performed.
Here is the Athabascan dance group showing their pride.
Here we are boogieing to the Athabascan twist. Finally, here we have Sitka's very own local Native American drummers.
Everyone danced along to the beat of the drum.
The dancing was great, but before we knew it, it was time to go.
Wow, that rocked. Great story, Bear. February the 16th was Elizabeth Paradovich Day.
In honor of Alaska civil rights leader, MEHS students led a parade through downtown Sitka. Chad was on the scene and captured all the action. Let's take a look.
The Elizabeth Paradovich Day parade was on the 16th of February, and the whole school went to go celebrate. Here's our Mount Edgecombe students heading to the parade. Here's our Mount Edgecombe High School dancers preparing for their parade.
My favorite part about Elizabeth Paradovich Day is performing, because I love performing. It's so much fun.
Here are the Goshahin dancers.
The parade was filled with dancers, singers, and regalia from across Alaska, all supporting civil rights and the spirit of Elizabeth Paradovich.
Here's Darren Deaton of Fairbanks, proudly leading the Athabascan dancers down Lincoln Street during the parade.
Here's our Mount Edgecombe Yupik dance group at the parade.
Thanks, Chad. After the parade, Sitkins gathered at the historic A&B Hall.
There was singing, dancing, and lots of good food.
My name is Sophia Andrew, and I'm a senior at Mount Edgecombe High School, and I'm from Marshall, Alaska. Today I got the honor to represent Elizabeth Paradovich in a reenactment played by Student Council. My favorite part of this experience was learning the history behind Elizabeth and her fight for our civil rights as Natives.
Hi, I'm Michaela Camera from St. Mary's, and my favorite part of Founders Week and the Culture Week was getting to know more people around, like, so many cultures coming into one and being noticed and showing that our culture is important to us.
My Tlingit name is Anugik, girl who shook the world when she was born. My English name is Vanessa Bradley, and I am from Sitka. I graduated from Mount Edgecombe High School in 2012, And my favorite part about Elizabeth Paradovich is bringing all of our people together to help our younger generations and our fellow community to help understand how important Elizabeth Paradovich has been, our native rights to be able to do and say what we want today.
On Thursday, Emil Nadi was the keynote speaker at the Byron Nicolai concert.
Let's go check it out. Nico and Chaelin have the story.
MEIJS invited alum Emil Nadi as the keynote speaker. After graduating from EdEdgecom, Nadi went on to be the first president of the Alaska Federation of Natives. He was instrumental in passing the Alaska Native Claims Settlement Act of 1971. He is a great example of MEIJS students growing up to become Alaskan leaders.
Byron Nicolai came and visited our esteemed school. He is a widely known Yupik singer and dancer. He is from the small village of Tuksuk Bay and is a real-life example of if you set your mind to something and try hard enough, you could get it. We welcomed him with open arms and we were obviously happy he came.
My name is Sophia Andrew and I'm from Marshall.
My name is Corey Itatomas and I'm from Barrow.
My name is Byron Nicolai and I'm from Tuksuk Bay.
Okay, Byron, if you could sum up your experience here in Sitka in three words, what three words would you use?
Explore, because I'm never able to explore when I go to other places, so that's a big one. Spirit, as you could see from what happened. Last one. Memorable, because it's going to be memorable.
I asked what about you and mom, then he just walked away.
What I like to say during interviews is that no matter who you are or where you come from, anything is possible, and I'm not just saying that. Take it from me. I used to be from village of Tuksuk Bay, and I thought, growing up, I thought I was just going to have a normal, regular life. But now that drum has brought me a lot of places, and it helped me meet the president. So anything really is possible.
Whoa! We sure showed our spirit.
Here's our very own Caitlin Moses dancing with her cousin Byron.
To make the performance even sweeter, we shared a delicious cake and took some nice pictures with a young artist.
It was awesome. Friday night was the founder's dance and it was popping. Let's go hit the dance floor.
I came to dance. After a great founder's week, the students were ready to boogie. That's Caleb, Colin, and Trenton. That's Breezy Ann and Tara. That's Disco Darren and Linda. And that's a big bunch of Braves. Now get ready, here comes the royalty. Jarvis and Ariana. Brayden and Kelby. Eric and Andrea. And of course, Nathan and Natasha.
A big thank you to Rachel Marino for organizing the Founders Week. The weatherman is calling out for a foot of snow tonight. What do you think, Bear?
Doesn't really look like it.
Yeah. Meanwhile, while the Brambas were fast asleep, the snow began to fall.
And it kept falling. And falling. And then it fell some more.
How's that meteorology class going along?
It was good. I just came back from a test.
So remember,
don't throw snowballs!